Good evening and welcome to this Monday edition of Rota News Watch. I'm Navy journalist James Smith. Anytime you see the CBs on base, they're always working hard. This weekend, NMCB 40 took a break from their demanding routine for a little R&R. Navy journalist Eric Rushton constructed this story about how the CBs celebrate their milestones.
Naval Mobile Construction Battalion 40 celebrated its mid-tour hump party Saturday, June 16th, with barbecue, volleyball, and live music. NMCB 40 has been in Rota for 3 months. With just 3 months left, many CBs are looking forward to getting their jobs finished and hitting the airways to visit their families. Even though Steelworker 3rd Class Harley Jeanette has planned out her visits in the States, she really doesn't want to leave Rota all that soon.
Oh, I love Spain. It's beautiful here. Sevilla, Rota, Jerez, hillbilly hill towns, as far as Spaniards are concerned, it's just beautiful. There's too much to do and not enough time. It should just be longer. Deployment in Spain should be longer. There's just too much to do. You know it's that for true.
The CBs will be working on their roof job, CFC, Building 160, and the laundry facilities during the time they have left on Naval Station. Reporting for Rota News Watch, I'm Navy journalist Eric Rushton.
The CBs have a tough job and deserve every break available.
CBs of Naval Mobile Construction Battalion 40 are completing a humanitarian project in Cape Verde, Africa. The 34 CBs are constructing a two-story, 5,000-square-foot shelter and education facility for orphans and abused children. Cape Verde has underdeveloped living conditions, and crew leader BU-2 James Dolan says most of the crew has never been exposed to such widespread poverty.
Well, at first, I know eyes opened wide, and everyone's pretty much accepted it and kind of helped out where they can. Some of the Cape Verdeans, they aren't as fortunate as we are with what we have, so I know some of the guys have been giving them some deodorant and small items that it's a lot harder for them to come by. I definitely see a lot of the crew seeing and being grateful for what they have back in the States.
The project was also the first time the CBs have worked with the Cape Verde military. While working together, the CBs trained the Cape Verdeans in the construction skills they will need to do similar projects in the future.
The people that we have met have been fantastic. It's a very poor country, and the things that they have to offer to everybody, their friendship, their music, and the wonderful food, it's been an absolutely fantastic experience. Definitely the pinnacle of my career so far.
With ribbon cutting scheduled for August 20th, these CBs are leaving a very positive landmark in their wake. Reporting from Cape Verde, Africa, Navy journalist Denny Webb.
Came out here, we were doing a lot of heavy duty work, and these guys kept going and going, and we looked at them like, damn, they're making us look bad. So then we stepped it up, and then like both teams on high, you know, picking on all cylinders right now. Pretty high speed guys.
Keep on teaching. entire crew that we have. These guys have been outstanding. It's not my building, it's their building. And then we'll turn it over to the Cape Verdeans when we leave.